r/AskReddit what's your best true spooky story? Serious. While at uni my friends and I ran out of booze. Hardly any shops were open because it was late on. So the only option was to walk the mile or so to the nearest 24-hour supermarket. Between the supermarket and the dorms we lived in was just row after row of suburban houses which all looked the same. As we were walking down one road we passed a field with a large campfire and some people riding horses around it. There were people playing musical instruments, and general sounds of a good time going on, the horses and fire, and the lanterns which were dotted about, gave it a very old-fashioned feel. Maybe 5 minutes after passing the field, now walking past houses again, one of my friends commented on how weird and out of place that gathering of people had been. My other friend and I had been thinking exactly the same thing, so, curious, we turned around and walked back to find out exactly what was going on. There was nothing there. Not just no people or horses, there was no field, just more and more houses. Even though we were absolutely certain we were on the right road, as we'd simply turned around, we walked up and down the neighboring roads too. We found nothing. We weren't drunk, though we'd had some drinks, and so I've got absolutely no idea what happened that night. I've posted this on my other account. Copying and pasting it here. The scariest thing I've had happen while camping. So I live in Eastern Oregon, and my mom lives in Western Oregon. I went to visit her for the summer and she's very outdoorsy, so we decided to take the 1 hour drive from her city to the coast. We end up at this free campsite at the top of this hill, huge foothills of the coastal mountains, about a 25 minute drive from the top where the campsite is to the bottom where the main road was, and we were the only campers there. We relaxed for the rest of the day, made food, etc. A truck full of men drive up the hill and talk with my mom. IDK what about, wasn't suspicious at the time, and they leave us. Fast forward to the middle of the night. I wake up to my mom sitting straight up in the tent. I wake easily so I heard her gasp and it woke me. As soon as she saw I was awake she put her hand over my mouth because I was starting to ask her what's wrong. It was dead silent and all of a sudden you hear footsteps right beside the tent. The little flap that covers the zipper was even moving. Thankfully my mom has quick wits and said very loudly, "Kenny, grab the gun, Kenny is my dad," although that doesn't matter, and mind you he was not there, just us girls like I previously said. They left. No harm was done. Thank the Lord for my mama. TLDR. Two girls at a campsite alone. People outside tent in the middle of the night and damp. My mom pulled some awesomeness. I went to use the bathroom at work and when I entered, there was no one in there. The bathroom has four urinals and four stalls, one handicap, and I did not see any feet in any of the stalls. I took up my normal spot inside one stall and was doing my business, when I heard the sound of someone peeing into one of the urinals, but no one had entered the bathroom. The door is heavy and loud when it closes, so I would have heard someone entering. After a normal amount of time, the peeing stopped, and I heard a few footsteps. But the door never opened. When I finished up I did a cursory look and there was no one in the bathroom. It's a ridiculous story, but I definitely heard a pee ghost. Are the male and female bathrooms right next to each other? If the walls are thin or sound carries, maybe you just heard the forceful pee of a co-worker in the women's room. At my old job, you could hear the guys farting through the walls. Sounded like they were in there. Nope. Female bathrooms are way down the hall. The only rational explanation is a ghost with a full bladder. Agreed. 4 years ago, I lived in a very large farmhouse that was converted into two apartments. The house was known as the old boys' home. It was used to house boys with behavioral issues but was closed due to allegations of molestation. Anyway, I was living with my boyfriend and 3-year-old daughter at the time. My bedroom had a large fireplace that had been boarded up and painted over. I decided to push my bed up against it one day while I was rearranging things. It was like a headboard. That night, around 1 a.m. I had heard a small voice saying "Mom, Mom, Mommy." I had sat up in bed but didn't see anything, so I reached over my boyfriend trying to grab down to grab my daughter and put her in our bed. I kept feeling around and I was still hearing the voice but I couldn't feel her. My boyfriend woke up and turned a bedside lamp on asking me, "What the hell are you doing?" I explained that Amelia was trying to get in our bed and I was reaching for her. There was nobody there. My daughter was sound asleep in her room. Then the next night came. Around 1 a.m. again, my dog had started to whimper at our door, so my boyfriend got up to take him outside. You know that feeling in a bed when someone lies down next to you? Where the bed pushes in and there is a warmth in your back. I felt that, so I assumed my boyfriend had come back to bed. I rolled over. My boyfriend wasn't in the bed and I felt the freaking bed release pressure. Whatever was laying next to me has gotten up in that second. I moved my bed the next day to the other side of the room and I never had another incident in the 2 years I remained in that house. I tell this story a lot and no one ever believes me, but I know what I saw. I was staying at my grandparents for the summer when I was 14. It was 11 p.m. and I was thirsty. Go out to the kitchen and see who I thought was my granddad sitting at the table eating a sandwich. I say hello, grab a glass of water and head back to my room. My grandfather comes out of his room and asks who I was talking to. I turn around and no one was there. It freaked me out, still does to this day. When my grandparents bought their house for a family of 10, my grandpa found a fake wall upstairs. He tore it down to make more room for the family. Behind the wall were children's clothes and play toys, almost like they walked off the room in a hurry. My mom told me stories of sitting in her room and something circling the walls around her, sounding like wallpaper being torn. When she moved out, my aunt moved into the same room. She would wake up with pictures she hung up laying on her chest in the morning. My cousins also have stories of hearing footsteps coming up the stairs and stopping outside their door in the middle of the night. I still don't go upstairs at their house because it's always cold and I get weird vibes up there. Even in my adult life, I have scary dreams that take place in there upstairs. I posted this in a thread a while ago, but gonna do it again because it applies here. When I was in high school, my uncle would throw me a couple bucks to help babysit his kids with my aunt. They lived in a two-story house by the water, nice area. The kids were about 3 and 6. One day I was sitting in their den on my phone when I started to hear a baby crying. Thinking it was the 3-year-old, I headed to the bottom of the stairs to check and see if my aunt was up there dealing with it. I called for her a couple times with no response. The baby kept crying. I called for her one more time, and when I got no response, I started walking up the stairs. Then I heard my cousins and aunt playing outside. All the hairs on my body stood up and I literally felt a chill run down my spine. I quietly turned around, walked down the stairs, got in my car and drove away. The baby was still crying when I closed the door behind me. A few years later, I was drunk at a family party and told my uncle the story. He told me that he and his wife used to hear the baby too, and apparently the previous owners had a kid die of SIDS in that room upstairs. He's uber Catholic and had a mass said for the baby. He said after that it never happened again. Still gives me the willies when I talk about it though. At the time I was around 14, I'd asked my dad to wake me up early that morning at about 5 a.m. because I had some work to get done. That morning, I was woken up, and I flung my legs over the side of my bed. I felt a tug on both of them. What I thought at the time was just my dad trying to get me to hurry up. I reached over to pick up my phone and turned it on, 3:30 a.m., and I looked over at the black figure I assumed was my dad and it was gone. Something similar happened to me. I was about 11 and I saw my dad standing in my doorway staring at me at like 4 a.m. I was so confused because he almost looked mad. So I called out to him. No response. I blinked and he was closer. I blinked again. He was at the foot of my bed. I pulled my covers over my head and started screaming. Also, IDKY, but doppelganger dad had boxes with flamingos on it, and when my parents came running to my room, he had on his Flintstone pajama pants. I asked and apparently he does not in fact own flamingo boxes. Freshman year at my university. We had a creepy, old dorm on campus that no one was living in. Everyone generally avoided it because it just had an uncomfortable feeling when you got close to it and felt like you were being watched. There are rumored stories about it of two women dying there on separate occasions. One murder, one suicide, and they are the ones who haunt the building. One night, a friend was in a bad mood because his girlfriend had broken up with him, So I was walking around campus with him to let him get it off his chest and just trying to help him feel better. We walked past the dorm and I brought it up about it being haunted and was telling him the stories to try and take his mind off it. So, the way the bottom floor was set up, there were two doors on both sides of the building and the hallway ran the entire length of the building and you could see the other door. We walked up to one of the windows and were just looking down the hall when two girls walked out of a room, wearing clothes that looked like they were from the 70s 80s and stood there in the hall looking at each other, not speaking. Then, one girl slowly turned her head and looked straight at us, slowly turned her head back, then turned and walked the opposite way from us down the hall. So we ran to the other side of the building, but we couldn't find them. We came back to the original door, and watched them do the same thing all over again. We looked at each other and ran. This freaked me out for a while, especially after, when I was sleeping in my room and all my posters fell off the wall at the same time. After telling this story to another friend, he convinced me to go back with him and try to find a way in. We found an open window, which we later found out was the room the girl hung herself in, and climbed in and started walking down the hall. We wandered around the building a bit and just started to notice generally creepy things. Water faucets started coming on, we'd walk through one room and then back through and a chair would be moved. On the first floor, a desk was turned upside down under the stairwell. As we were getting close to leaving, a lot more water faucets came on and kept getting louder and louder. Then when we got back to the room to go back out of the window, and as we put our hands on the window, the door slammed closed, so we ripped the door open, dove out and ran back to our dorm, and never went back.
Thank you so much for watching this video, guys. If you enjoyed the content, be sure to leave a like, and don't forget to subscribe as well for more Reddit stories like this. Until next time.